Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's focus on these structural changes that happen to molecules as they are metabolized by enzymes in the liver. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to distinguish phase 1 and phase 2 metabolic reactions, list common phase 1 and phase 2 reactions, and summarize the role of hepatic metabolism in pharmacokinetics. Most small molecule oral drugs are cleared by hepatic metabolism. Other tissues and organs are possible sites of metabolism, but the liver is the primary site. There are two main types of metabolic reactions, phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 reactions are performed by the cytochrome P450 CYP family of enzymes. Phase 1 reactions include oxidations, reductions, and hydrolytic reactions. Phase 2 reactions are performed by other enzymes and involve conjugations, the addition of a group to the molecule to make a new metabolite. Very broadly speaking, drug will first undergo a phase 1 reaction, which may cleave off part of the molecule or otherwise create a new functional group to make a new metabolite. That metabolite will then undergo a phase 2 reaction, which will add a new group to make a more polar, less reactive metabolite that is more readily excreted by the kidneys or other organ. This generalization is not true for every drug, but is commonly observed. The cytochrome P450 enzymes catalyze most phase 1 reactions. There are many CYP enzymes, with just a handful being relevant for drug metabolism. CYP3A4, 3A5 are particularly important. Others include 2D6, 2C9, and 2C19. Most CYP reactions are oxidations and involve addition of an oxygen to a molecule, such as this oxidation of an aromatic ring in phenobarbital by CYP2C19, or cleavage of a methyl group from the nitrogen in diphenhydramine by CYP2C9. Reductions are less common, but are encountered from time to time. Phase 2 reactions are called conjugations because they add a group to a drug or metabolite. On the screen is a very common type of phase 2 conjugation. The reaction starts with our phase 1 metabolite of phenobarbital, a UDP-glucuonosyl transferase, UGT, another family of enzymes, adds a glucuronic acid group to the OH group. This reaction is called a glucuronidation. The metabolite, a glucuronide, is extremely polar and is readily cleared by the kidneys. Other phase 2 reactions include sulfations, addition of a sulfate, and glutathionylation, addition of glutathione. Each of these reactions make a metabolite that is very polar. As was mentioned before, phase 2 reactions often follow phase 1 reactions. Oxidative metabolism in phase 1 can generate reactive, toxic metabolites in the liver. Phase 2 reactions often minimize the reactivity of these metabolites, protect the liver from damage, and help remove products of drug metabolism from the body. The liver is not the only site of metabolism. So why does hepatic metabolism receive so much attention in this course? A main reason is that this course focuses on small molecule oral drugs. Oral drugs are subject to first-pass metabolism, both in the gut lining and the liver. Hepatic metabolism is the main driver of clearance for oral drugs. Understanding hepatic metabolism, starting with metabolic stability assays, gives direct insight into multiple pharmacokinetic parameters, including oral bioavailability, total clearance, and half-life. We have distinguished phase 1 and phase 2 reactions, as well as listed a handful of examples. Phase 1 reactions cover oxidations, reductions, and hydrolyses. Phase 2 reactions cover conjugations. Finally, we summarized the role of hepatic metabolism in determining drug pharmacokinetics. That was a quick summary of the types of changes molecules undergo during hepatic metabolism. If you enjoyed this video, please consider liking the video or subscribing to the channel. Take care.